Hello everyone, in this video we will be learning the use of S2+ for rigorous design of shell and tube heat exchanger. So basically we have learned how to design shell and tube heat exchanger manually without using any advanced software such as Aspen. But in this video we will learn how to get accurate values of all the parameters which we calculated or which we, you can say, estimated using our old or conventional method, which is known as Kern's method. As you have might have already figured out that there were very flaws in our method, for example the using of these graphs and estimating various values, and all there were so many flaws to be mentioned in this video. I mean point out several flaws in the previous designing method, which of course limit the efficiency of the design that we achieved using this method. So in this video we will basically learn the use of Aspen Plus to design a shell and tube heat exchanger which will of course be very useful. And this video is very important because in this video you will learn how to get an advanced design of a shell and tube heat exchanger just by a few clicks. I will show you how these are just a few clicks. So basically we will use the same conditions as we used in the previous video. It is the specification of our process team. So we have HCl, we have thiol chloride, we have ethylene, and then we have methanol. Let me recheck. Okay, so methanol is basically the utility stream. And we will move next. And in this method we will be using the SRG method because it is appropriate for our method, and we have already tested this simulation with NRTL. It doesn't work with NRTL. Okay, so use basically method assistant and you can analyze yourself which method is best for your system. Okay, we will move next. Okay, now we will enter the simulation page. I want to keep the video as short as possible so you guys won't be irritated by the length of the video. So it is basically the hot side inlet. It doesn't matter whether it is entering the shell side or fluid side, you can adjust the conditions inside the shell. I will show you later. You just have to put the specification of cold stream here, which is stream 3. Let me name it as cold in. Cold in. Cold out. So basically what is the cold stream? Methanol, of course. And what was the, and we have the flow rate of methanol. You know, you will have to calculate the flow rate of methanol using the energy balance. So basically you will first have to calculate the flow rate of methanol using either the energy balance, or you can use the heater pellet heater model to calculate the flow rate. You will have to refer to my previous video to learn how to use this model. Basically it is simpler than this one. I will you can check in my video how will you will be able to calculate the flow rate of methanol. Basically you just know the flow rate of you just know the flow rate of your process stream, which is coming from whatever the previous component was, and you will have to calculate yourself what should be the flow rate of your utility stream. I mean, it can be manipulated, it is not a fixed flow rate. So was it in kg per second? I guess. Okay, and what is the temperature? 255. Let's assume atmospheric pressure. Okay, we have entered the cold inlet conditions. You don't necessarily have to enter the output conditions. And what is the temperature of our process stream? It is 318 Kelvin. First, let me name it process in. Let's temperature to be 1 atmosphere. Let's enter the conditions. In this one we have kilomole per second. So basically you will have the conditions of your process stream given, like you will have temperature, pressure and your flow rates, but what you will have to find yourself is the flow rate of methanol. Just okay, so our input is complete. Next we will move on to our shell and tube. First of all, you will have to select the model to be shortcut, and let's say we are keeping our hot fluid on tube side. Okay, and let's select the design to be counter current approach of design. So what we will be inputting is hot stream outlet temperature. And what is, which one is our hot stream? It is our process stream. And what we want to, what we want to achieve here is 272 Kelvin. Let's simply run our simulation. Oh, it's saying results are available. Okay, it's saying results are available. Let me first show you the results, then we will move on to the advanced designing of shell and tube heat exchanger. So what will be the temperature of this one is methanol cold outlet. You see this temperature is very low, it means that it is not achievable at all. You see the temperature approach, it is suggesting that is too high and it is not achievable at all. Can you imagine achieving 272 Kelvin? It means that there is mistake in this assumed problem. However, theoretically we designed a complete shell and tube heat exchanger without bothering this condition, while this Aspen is telling us that it is not. Okay, we have process out, we have cool out. What is the temperature of cold out?
Why can't I see the temperature? Oh, this one is the temperature.
The process is in liquid temperature for the rice. Cold in sorry. It is achievable. The methanol is that is entering at very low temperature. I didn't realize that it is already entering below 25 degrees C. So of course that temperature is achievable. 272 was that. I don't know how he will be achieving this temperature of methanol, but as far as it is given in this problem, the design is accurate for the given conditions. Next, we will learn how to design the internals of Shaolin tube heat exchanger. Simply select Shaolin tube here and click. You see what we will be designing. Size, we will be sizing the exchanger. We don't yet have to select you see geometry. Simply click convert. So first of all, you will have to run the simulation by using shortcut, and secondly you will have to run the simulation using second. So basically proposed something timer type B. It is a shell passes. You can study all these, what are the G split and F split. All these information is available in Coulson volume 6. Basically integrated with flat cover. You see these are the specifications. It selected itself. Now we will click on size and it will do literally each and everything itself. That's why I was telling you all that this video is very important. If you want to learn the precise design of shallow tube heat exchanger, you see I literally entered nothing and it is about to give me a perfect design for my shallow tube heat exchanger. But we will be getting size, outer dia, we will be getting all the things tube outer pitch, and literally each and everything will be given to me. There we go. Number of tubes per pass. Varmone 2 shell internal dia, tube length, baffle spacing, we have literally each and everything. We have mass flow rate, internal pressure, allowable pressure drop. No maximum level pressure, but okay, we didn't specified. It is not you see serious error. You did not input any falling resistances, and yes, we didn't specify falling resistances. If you want to specify falling resistances, you can add them. They are already available in Coulson volume 6. I will show you how you can find the falling factor, the falling resistances. You see, based upon the nature of the fluid, you can select falling resistance from here and put its value in the mentioned units. So we didn't need it. I think all we know is that we have completed our design. So if you want to accept design, click it. So here we have our design of shell and tube heat exchanger. Do we have to run it again? Okay, we rename it. Let's see the results. What is our actual exchanger area? We have 551 meter square required. What is the heat duty? What is percentage? You see, we were these are our pressure drop conditions. These are our thermal conditions. It is our tube sheet layout. These are the profile layouts. T bulk distance from end. Temperature profile basically. So guys, I think this video was quite useful, and please do not forget to subscribe my channel, as you guys have been watching all my videos and literally I have less than 100 subscribers, which I think is not fair. So please subscribe my channel and help me, you see, produce more useful videos for you.